Hi friends, new education policy has come and people are literally debating it on television and the print media. I'm not here to tell you the fine details of the new education policy, that you'll have to read it yourself and you'll have to do it research whether it fits you, whether you like it and what you don't like it. But this new education policy was much awaited because for a long, long time there has been no change in the education policy. It was much needed, no doubt about it. And India being a knowledge hub, we definitely need to be ahead of time. So with this, I don't guarantee or feel that we will be ahead of everyone, but then we must not forget that India is among the top 5 economic powers of the world, and even with respect to knowledge hub and intellectual and wisdom, considering our civilization, we are among the top 3 or 4 civilizations in the world. Now I'll talk about the intent. The intent of the National Education Policy is very clear, and that is we need to stress more on practical things, more on vocational education and more on enhancing our skills, which is only possible if we introduce vocational study much earlier in our life. As you must have seen, in this new education policy, the schooling education has been broken into parts. Earlier, we used to focus on 10th and 12th, but now it's not the same. Schooling has also been divided into parts. In the first part, every Indian must have certain core knowledge, then later on vocational studies have been introduced. The change in national education policy does not cover medical sector and the legal sector. There has been no change in policy with regard to medical education and the legal education. I was listening to Mr. Kasturirangan, who was part of this committee, and he is very happy with the policy. Now I'll go through the fine things with the intent. So if you join it after having passed school, and once you join a graduation, and if for some reason you happen to leave the course because of certain situations in life, somebody expired in your house, you don't have that much money, or whatsoever reason, good or bad. So whatever part you have covered, if you have covered a duration which entitles you to give diploma, you'll get a diploma degree, not a full-fledged degree. And if you have done the full course, you'll get a degree. So even if you join a course and if you happen to leave at a certain level, you will be at least attending to a certificate or a diploma or a degree. Certificate is always 1 year, diploma is 2 to 3 years, and degrees most of the time 3 to 4 years. So depending on the duration you have completed, you will get a certificate, diploma or a degree. So that one thing is very clear. So if suppose you join a course and you don't happen to like it to a larger extent, do the diploma, finish diploma, come out with a diploma degree and join another course, and you can have 2 diplomas in different fields. So graduation can be done in a very short time with 2 diplomas in different fields. So that is also one possibility. You don't have to wait for 3-4 years to finish a degree, then you lose the interest and you lose the time for or doing another field. It also happens with many of the people. And other best thing which I liked in this is that stress has been given more on vocational studies. Like I remember, though I am a doctor, but I happened to learn typing at school level and also at my internship level when I was doing medicine. Typing is very important. This I realized long back. So now I can type without looking at the keyboard. So few things like this must be imbibed in the school time only. Other thing which I haven't found but is equally important is that government should come out with a resource center wherein all the lectures, all the education should be converted into a video lectures. Many of us are aware that during Doordarshan time and even now, UGC has uploaded many videos, educational videos. They are not simply education for everyone, but they are very much in line with the curriculum of the course. So such educational videos should be equally easily available on various platforms, and the government should create a resource for it, a library for it. Now nobody goes to Delhi Public Library or certain libraries, state libraries. So many of us prefer to watch a video or a PowerPoint presentation. So government should create a resource for it, number one. Number two, when I was doing my graduation and post-graduation and even while I was doing management course, I realized that professors are fine, professors are good, they have been teaching us on various topics, marketing, management and all, but then we have leaders in our industry also. Every college, be it medical, like those who are in medical sector, they can invite people from medical fraternity, those who are celebrities like Naresh Trehan or head of Narayan Hridayalaya, Dr. Devi Shetty, then people from pharmaceutical area, those whom we see in the TV channels, in business channels. So such people should be invited in the classroom as a guest lecturer. They should give certain tips, and if possible, if they have time, to even take a lecture of an hour or two so that they can give us important inputs. So this is an example in the medical field. Similarly, from the field of engineering, many bigwigs can come to the engineering colleges and give certain tips which no books can give, no video education can give. Similarly, in the field of, now we have smart classes at the school level, similarly we can have the same at the college level. Other thing which I like to add over here is, like in Delhi education area, we need to have full-fledged teachers, professors, no doubt about it, they should be on the roll, but equally important is we should have some guest lecturer also. There are many in the field of medical education, there are many who are well flourishing doctors, celebrity doctors. Similarly, we have very good engineers, we have intellectuals and wise people, knowledgeable people in all walks of life. So such people should be invited to colleges to take certain classes as a part of curriculum or as a mentor to give tips, and they should also be paid for it. That's what I mean to say. Though they are very rich people, they are very leaders of the thing, but at least attempt should be made to pay them also and to facilitate them also and to honor them also, so that new budding chaps should get tips from the wise industry people and also some inputs in their curriculum. So that was it. I was not here to debate about national education policy as such, but then there are certain good things which I have recently found which are good in our new education policy, and something what I added today should be also a part of it. We need to change That's what I was trying to talk about. Thank you, friends. Hope you liked my idea, and hope those who are intellectual in our society and the big wigs carry the message to those who have the power to change our education policy.